Dear first BBA students, welcome you all to the third video lesson on OAS, that is Office Automation Systems. OAS refers to the computer machinery and software which is used to digitally create, collect, store, manipulate and share office information within a local area network. Main types of OAS tools include MS Word, MS Excel and MS PowerPoint. This software saves time and money by placing all of the documents and resources in one place and thereby allows an organization to become virtually paperless and fully digital. Come on, let us know about the OAS tools one by one. First OAS tool is MS Word. It is a word processor designed for creating, saving and printing text-based documents. It helps to type text, change the font, color, size and other style settings for a text by using Word's built-in options. It facilitates in copying, pasting, moving and deleting text within a document. Its major functions include convert a list to a table, convert a bulleted list to smart art, does spelling and grammar check, change case, finding and replacing text, inserting watermarks, inserting header and footer, mail merge operations, macros, using hyperlinks automatically and still many more. Let us now have an idea about 5 document views used in MS Word. Print layout. This is a view of the document that we need as hard copy. It includes all tables, text, graphics and images. Full screen reading. It is a full view of a document and it is good for viewing 2 pages at a time. Web layout. This view of the document would be as it appears in a web browser. Outline. This is an outline form of the document in the form of bullets. And final document view is draft. This view does not display pictures or layouts, rather it displays only text. Next is about styles in MS Word. A style is a format enhancing tool which is available in the home tab of the Word ribbon. Header and footer. A header is a text at the top of the page of a document. On the other hand, a footer is a bottom of the page of a document. Headers and footers are that you want to appear on every page of your document, such as organization name, title of the document or page number. Advanced features of MS Word include mail merge and macros. Mail merge. It enables you to merge a data source into a copy of a document to customize or personalize the document. Moreover, it allows us to create multiple documents at once, such as letters, saving our time and effort of retyping the same letter over and over again. The other feature of MS Word is macros. A macro is a series of commands and instructions that we group together as a single command to accomplish a task automatically. It speeds up editing or formatting often than in a Word document. Second OAS tool is MS Excel. MS Excel is a program used for data analysis and documentation. It is a spreadsheet program which contains number of columns and rows. Finance and accounting are the business areas where Excel spreadsheets are the most used tools to get financial and budgetary analysis or forecasts. It helps to store and sort data represented in tables. Data manipulations can be done with the help of formulae and Excel functions. Moreover, it helps to produce graphs and charts and thereby supports interpretation of data. Come on, let us have a view on the components of spreadsheet in MS Excel. Name box. Under the Excel ribbon, there is a white box displaying a name like A1. That small box is called the name box. Insert function button. On the right side of the name box, there is a gray box with an FX button. That FX button is called the insert function button. Formula bar. On the right side of the insert function button is a long empty white box or section called the formula bar. Cell. A cell is the intersection of a column and a row, which helps to store data such as number, word, equation, formula, function, color or image. Worksheet tabs. On the left side of the horizontal scroll bar, there are the worksheet tabs where we can enter data, edit and format them. On the left side of the worksheet tabs, there are four navigation buttons, which helps to move from one worksheet to another. Come on, let us see the salient features of MS Excel. Formula. A formula is an expression that operates on values in a range of cells or a cell. Every formula begins with a equal to sign. For instance, equal to A1 plus A2, which helps to find the sum of the values stored in the cell A1 and A2. Functions. Functions are predefined formulae and are already available as built-in one in MS Excel. For instance, equal to sum of the range A1 to A5 is a function in Excel which helps to add range of numbers stored in A1, A2, A3, A4 and A5 cells respectively. Tables and charts. Tables can be created and formatted to visually group and analyze data. The tabulated data are graphically represented as charts such as bar chart, pie chart, line chart and so on. The third and the final office automation system tool is MS PowerPoint. PowerPoint presentation is a computer program that allow you to create and show slides to support a presentation. It can contain text, graphics and multimedia content to create professional presentations for office meetings, lectures and seminar. It creates maximum impact in a minimal amount of time. Moreover, it can amplify the message, accelerate the information being observed and assist with comprehension, enabling faster decision making. Let us highlight the components of PowerPoint. The four major components are slide pan, placeholder, thumbnail and notes pan. Let us discuss about them one by one. Slide pan. This is the area which is used to create one slides. Placeholders. On each slide, you will see various boxes with the dotted borders, which are called placeholders. This is the place which is used to insert objects such as text, pictures, smart art graphics, clip art, charts, tables, diagrams, movies and sound. Thumbnail. The slide which is working will be highlighted in the left of the slide pan. And the last component is notes pan. It is in the bottom of the slide. This is where one types speaker notes. It can be referred while presenting a slideshow. It can also be taken as printout. Now, let us discuss about the highlighting features of MS PowerPoint. Slide layout and design. Slide layouts define containers, positioning and formatting for all the content that appears on a slide. Slide design is a theme which includes a background design, color scheme, font type, font size and placeholder positions in one package. The next feature is slide animation and transition. Slide animations are applied to individual objects on a single slide. On the other hand, slide transitions are applied to a whole slide. Now, coming to the last feature of PowerPoint, slideshow. It is the projection of a set of slides to the audience with animation and transition effects. Hope you all had a clear-cut idea about office automation system and its three major tools, which can help you in preparing certificate, biodata, newspaper model and multi-column model in MS Word, mock sheet in MS Excel, and finally slide with animation and advertisement for a product in MS PowerPoint. Thank you. All the very best.